It's the mindset. Free your mind.
Free your mind.
Mindset. Free your mind.
Free your mind.
Hey, not everything that glitters is gold. Everything that's white is snow. On the mindset, I just start. Let them know. Let them know. Let them know. Oh, words from the wise. I just start. We will never lie. Stand tall, we will never die. We'll forever shine. I just star, shine like the star in the sky. Some hate, some love.
That we hear going out there, that the movement have lost that militancy about it because of, you know, recent things that we see. Public figure as you know, even Rasta artists we see out there now. Rasta celebrate Christmas, Rasta celebrate Easter, and all of that.
Call it Rasmus.
Yeah.
Call it Rasmus. What kind of madness is that? Rasta call the center. I just heard it as Rasmus. I get lost again. I go around the corner, I get lost again. Oh, Iceland's birthday become Rasmus. You know, man, I celebrate all Ethiopian Christmas, 7th of January, 6th of January, all them something. We have our own things where we do that celebrate. Marcus Garvey birthday, Emancipation Day, you know, Iceland's Earth Day, Coronation Day. All of these things we celebrate. I know we have tried. It's like a man of us said, Jesus black. You know, oh, him get Jesus for the black and him do the same thing with the white Jesus said, do. And him have the same thinking like the white Jesus. But all him do is change the color. That don't make no sense. You can't change the color. It's not the color why you say about it, you know. It's because of the thinking. And the thinking say, Jesus turned water into wine, him dead, him raised again. And I know you are saying, Jesus black. But you still have said the black Jesus turn water into wine, raise the dead, feed 5,000 people with fish and this and that and that. A joke business. You can't. It's not the color that. It's not the color. You know, see, it's where you read about this so-called Jesus Christ in the Bible and I try to interpret the thing. You know, see. So when you say black Jesus, now you feel more secure in yourself. But then now you go back now in the mythology of the white Jesus. You know, you don't create a space to develop your own consciousness and awareness as it relates to a black Jesus. What you do is just swap the marker dog with puppy. You know, you don't say, all right, you have a praise of black Jesus, but everything with the white Jesus, where you think the white Jesus know, you say the black Jesus to do it. It's a kind of mad business. It's a psycho, you know, we traumatized, brethren. We traumatized to the point where we want to believe in Adam and Eve. We want to believe that God made the end of the earth in a 6 day. So we have to keep Sabbath. We want to believe all these things. And then now, for those of us who claim our conscious, we say, yeah, but in Ethiopia, we turn back to Ethiopia. I say, yeah, but you know, the church in Ethiopia. The church in Ethiopia is not that they decide Rastafari concept. Rastafari concept was there. Hello?
Yeah, man, it wasn't the church that did that say Haile Selassie is God, is Rasta in a Jamaica.
No, Rasta
did
I say that?
Yeah.
So we can't over say no. Through the church in Ethiopia do this and the church in Ethiopia do that. Me must do it too. Because the church in Ethiopia now say Haile Selassie. As a matter of fact, they are the biggest fight against Haile Selassie. When Haile Selassie is going to turn over the land to the people there, because the church is the biggest landowners in Ethiopia. And when Haile Selassie is going to turn over the land to the people, they fight against him. I say, where you talk about? Fight, turn over land to where? So all the big landlords them and the kings them, want to say, boy, Haile Selassie, I joke all this thing about him and turn over land. To the normal person, which land is power. If you don't have the land, you don't have no power. And that is really where scare certain things. Because here we know, Silonga so now, and I develop. We are the only group of people that was, what we call our ancestors were former slaves. We will develop a religion in the Western world. Can you believe that? We develop a religion in the Western world. And that religion, if you want to call it a religion, is Rastafari. We base up of our Emperor Haile Selassie in Africa. So we know we don't know for say why we can't Ethiopia this and Ethiopia that. We have a book with that. The cross and Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is not even Ethiopian. Ethiopia is not even Ethiopian, Nikita. But you really take it. Ethiopia, Greece, Greek. You know, Jesus Christ is Greek. There's no word for Jesus Christ in the Amharic language. Them adapt Jesus Christ out of the Greek language and put it there so. You know, see, and them don't want to use the Hebrew word, which is Yahushua. Yahushua would have better use Yahushua than I talk about Jesus and Jesus Christ. You know, see, but nobody now look at it them really. We as Rastafari define ourselves. We are very unique people. You plan to say, the strangest man them in the world, the strangest people them in the world. You know, Rastafari, and we come develop that. And now we are turning it over to Christian thinking, Christian mind. Whether it's a Roman Catholic, Orthodox Church or whatsoever. It's not the way. Rastafari is a movement that was formed to deal with colonialism and white supremacy over black people. That is really the fight. You know, it's a liberation movement. It's not a religion. It's not somewhere you go pray every day and I say, yes, I say I will protect you and guide you and you know anybody will fight against you, jog or lick them though. That is not Rastafari. That is where Rastafari become. It's like we see them below temple up in a temple. In a Naya Bingi, no one about priests in a Naya Bingi. Oh, you have priests in a Naya Bingi. Naya Bingi is a war against evil forces coming from the woman Naya Bingi in a Uganda. And we understand that it's not a religion. And then all them are read the same thing, I quote the same book, them, same Bible verses in a Naya Bingi. When we just start going to Naya Bingi, never have no tabernacle. Man, a bonfire against the system, bonfire against anything. Man, we are near meat, bonfire against man, we go to church. Them thing that we know about. But no man stand up in a tabernacle and I preach. And also now them have turned it all in an organization. They must say them have secretary and organize. Naya Bingi is not an organization of business people. You know, see, if you have a farm organization, your farm is separate from the Naya Bingi. You know, see, it's just that, you know, you have a farm is separate from the Naya Bingi, but you can't include business of order and secretary and treasurer and all that in a Naya Bingi. That is not the purpose of Naya Bingi.
So, all right.
You have to organize yourself differently.
Let me ask the idea, Smoota. So, the phrase or the term Naya Bingi theocracy. Where does it come from?
Joke business. Theocracy is theo mean God. Right? And theocracy is a government where God rule.
Right.
But who is ruling when you say God rule? Because nobody's not going to sit down and say I am God and I rule. It's the same like a priest saying it's like Iran. Iran is a theocratic state. But who ruled Iran? It's a clergy them. And them talk that like Moses. In the Bible now, you have this supposed to be autocratic thing, and God say. Who say God say? It's Moses that say God say and the Levite precept. So them going on this tabernacle where the Ark of the Covenant there. Where the people them can't go in because you have not even flat nosed people, 1 foot people, none of them kind of people that can enter the tabernacle. It's only the priests them, the Levite them from Moses' tribe can go into the tabernacle. And when them go in there, they make certain laws and come out and tell the people them say, God say. You know, see, that is really the trick in the thing, you know. So in Iran now, when them say this is a theocratic government, God not sitting down, Allah not sitting down at the prime minister's desk. It's the clergy them are sitting down there. So when a man comes and says, theocratic Rastafari must have a theocratic government. I just say, not going to sit down there and tell you what to do. It's man going to do that. It's we ordinary Rastafari version going to do that. So I now adopt a theocratic way, because I see that lead to now the domination of man over man again. And you have that in the Bible, theocratic, where Moses attack, and Moses say, God say, and everything them say, God say, God say, and at them I say it. No, God not say nothing. At them I say it.
All right. So, all right.
Just like in Iran.
Yeah.
When I'm talking about Allah, Allah say, if you go chop off a man neck and all them, and type vampire, you will get 73 virgin in heaven and all them something. It's crazy. It's crazy.
So, when you look on the Bobo Shanti movement, Zin, which is a dominant movement within Rastafari, I would say, because when you look around the world now, you see, you know, Bobos from all angles. Are even people who say them a Bobo, Zin? But what did I make of the movement itself of Bobo Shanti being Prince Emmanuel even being a part of the Trinity of Marcus and Haile Selassie?
All right, you miss that now. Me love when a man can go into himself and create his own concept. The problem we have the concept now is that they have validated it through the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
See? That means if a man ever tell me, say, Prince Emmanuel, Marcus Garvey, and Haile Selassie is a Trinity, me not have no problem with it, you know. Because it's black people who find themselves in themselves. You know, see, so you say, well, Prince Emmanuel, Haile Selassie, and you say, okay, a one in three and three in one. Me not have no problem with it. The problem with me have now is when a man will turn, open the Bible and show you say it in the Bible. I mean, no, say, it not in there. Nothing about that not in there. Me and a man wilder than I find the radio, true man tell me about. And me ask him, a daughter asked me, who was Melchizedek?
Mm-hmm.
Mother. Not who was Melchizedek, mother. Who was Prince Emmanuel, mother? And when born. So I go find out, say, born as Saint Elizabeth. But I never find out who's the mother. A man cussed me upon the radio and I said, when me did I talk about Prince Emmanuel, nobody don't know how Prince Emmanuel, mother. I said, then you must have mother. The man begs with me. To me, say, Prince Emmanuel have a mother. I said, then you know if any man will not have no mother. I said, Melchizedek. The Bible says Melchizedek neither have mother nor father. You know why them say that? Why them say Melchizedek have no mother nor father? Because he must not have the priesthood. He must have the priesthood.
Right.
They never define him within the priest, the priestly levels where they talk about in Israel. Them say the Levite, they're supposed to be priests.
Right. And
no man no come here so and no ban. Who can be so stupid to believe a man upon the earth we do have no mother nor no father?
So
that is stupid.
Yeah, that is madness, man. Every flesh will walk through here if it come through.
Yeah, so the argument is that if you really are deal with a rebirth of your consciousness and awakening, all power to that. We love that. But don't come round, come and validate it through a book where confuse the people them over the years and all them stuff. Because me love the Bubba House, me love the discipline we used to there. And notice me say used to, you know.
Mm.
Me love where go on, at least we used to go on. You know, when Prince Emmanuel, they tell me say, him wa them Bubba them come on the radio, my cutting edge program in the early days. Me say, of course. And then next week, me say a busload of them come along I refrain that all. Mr. Young get scared. Me say, no, Mr. Young, you don't have to get scared. I'm going to put them on the radio. That have before Sizzle and Cape Town and all them on there. And when me spend the whole 4 hours with them, and next year, Prince Emmanuel say, why? Well, I'm give thanks because the first time, them really get fit. Say what they want to say on the radio. I'm going to say, next time, you know, Prince Emmanuel present home on them. And the next time he send home on them, you know, see?
Balance.
I feel said that is where, cause the whole, you know, igniting of the Prince Emmanuel, because them here for the first time on the radio, who was the Bubba House, you know, it's more than man who has said room. You know, but when you look on the whole argument, it's like 12 tribe. 12 tribe was the most organized set of rascals in Jamaica. But them have a man named God, no way say him as a prophet, and everybody has said he's a prophet. And him are carrying out to the 12 tribe of Israel because him couldn't acquire no land in Ethiopia for the Federation when was when the lab Charter 15. And then now him decides, all right, he will go around the corner and get some land separate and never get it. So he say, all right, here we're going to do. We're going to stamp call the House Federation and call it the 12 tribe of Israel. Because we have more claim to land in Israel than we are there. So Fim's idea was to gather 12 tribes and go to Israel, just like the Hebrew Israelites them. It's just that Hebrew Israelites are a bit more practical and then go down and go create a community in the moon of Israel. We're dead still, even though it kind of get diminished because the dead, the leader dead. But him now, Brother Gad, was found wanting. And even though him start a good thing, but like any other leader again, after a while them get corrupt and start to do certain things that you said, no, this not going to work, but I see it now. 12 Tribe of Israel, one of the most biggest and most respected Rasta organization where allow uptown middle class youth to come side Rasta because of the explanation with them gay according to the Bible. It's now just a little organization where keep your stage show and party and dance.
And the ISL Rasta is not that. Right.
Rasta is a movement of liberation with a spiritual nucleus. It's a black power movement with a spiritual nucleus. It comes to awake the African people out of them slumber. But it don't just come like the Black Panther Party in the 60s. It comes with a cultural expression. You know, and it also comes with a divine awareness of self by looking at Emperor Selassie I, you know, so it goes to the next level of consciousness, you know, and that is really what it is all about. It's all about revolution, not only in the political sphere, but also in the spiritual sphere, the consciousness.
True. I hear the I mention the virgin that came on a program, couple programs, Honorable Priest Lindell Zane from the Ethiopia Africa Black International Congress.
Oh, that's her name?
Yes.
You hear him?
Yeah, he's an honorable priest. Yeah, man, a good virgin, man. Good virgin. All right, from all of that.
But him cuss I all the while. Him cuss I all the while, you know.
No, man, him not cuss that.
Him not. That's why I say, brethren, you really have to come by the middle of the night. Yeah? And him always call at the night. You know, Mr. Brethren, nobody just ease me up tonight. Ease me up. I have to tell him to ease me up.
My questions to the eye still, Zane. Regarding that little bit of conversation that we have with the priest.
Which one of them? Which conversation?
Well, both conversation. You see me, I said about 3 times a year him ring the eye. But
him call me about Prince Emmanuel in a king's house. When say Prince Emmanuel gay, I mean, I just like to give Prince Emmanuel a insignia.
Right.
I say, yeah, but I know only Prince Emmanuel did get the insignia in there. Sam Clay get the insignia. Chapo getting signal and all that. The man begs, you know, when you say that.
So,
the man begs.
What more ask there in our motor, Zane? Is it impossible for Haile Selassie to return back to Jamaica and the public don't know
on
about
a private visit?
Yes. Is it an impossible thing?
In a taxi?
No, I'm not talking about a taxi. May I ask the
Haile? Man, if, say, man.
No, but yeah, but me not talk about what the virgin them tell you, you know. Me ask the eye now, Zane, if it's impossible, Zane, for the king for return back to Jamaica on a private visit, yeah. And the public
without anybody know,
and the public of Jamaica don't know
to go and visit Prince Emmanuel.
No, me just ask you in general, is it impossible?
No, we can't talk about general, that specific thing we are dealing with.
We are talking about Prince Emmanuel, about Prince Emmanuel we are talking about.
No, listen to me. The argument when the brethren gave me years ago is that Haile Selassie came back to Jamaica on a private visit to visit Prince Emmanuel.
Yeah.
And him take a taxi and go down to which part of Prince Emmanuel there, and then him go back. That is madness. Total madness.
Why?
I said he's not going to travel alone first, that's the first thing. And he's not going to take no taxi to go to Prince Emmanuel. And why would he go into why would he be going to Prince Emmanuel?
So what the Aya say is what is so special about is that Prince Emmanuel that
mentality do that? Is that deluded in is the same deluded mentality when they say I just say show up at Apple and you and cut it 13 times before it.
No, but Anna,
it's a deluded thinking.
That Anna that we are talking about. We are talking about if it's impossible for the king to make a private visit without the public know about that.
And that no, the it can't happen. Because he would have to come through protocols.
Right. He would have to come through the protocol.
Kind of beard. I'm dressed up like another man.
No, that's an illusion. But what may I say is, you have a lot of...
Private visit is not private, you know. Private visit means say, him come for a specific thing, and him don't go at stadium, and him don't go on train, and all this. That's private visit. Private visit is like when a man, like the ambassador of America come here, and him go straight to the minister, to the prime minister. That is private visit. Private visit. The other visit now is when a man come and him have party in a king's house, him have that and that. Haile Selassie did not do it. Haile Selassie never come here for a private visit. It's one time Haile Selassie come to Jamaica. One time.
That is what they I know about.
What do you mean know about? Tell me next time when him come to Jamaica.
No, well, may I say, it the impossible for His Majesty to make
no,
a private
no, visit. No, no, that would be impossible from impossible. Tell me next time when Haile Selassie come to Jamaica. Because when I will entertain a full talk, you know.
No, well,
tell me a time when, tell me the next time when Haile Selassie come to Jamaica.
The only other time me hear about is the private visit with him and Prince Emmanuel.
Who said that to you? No, Bobo tell you that.
Yeah, Bobo. Yeah, well, I am Bobo.
Yeah, they don't see him. They don't see him. But the Bobo tell me say, me begs him to come and tell him say, I just say not, it's not ongo. Prince Emmanuel, I just say again, sing now. Prince Emmanuel, you know, Capo, you ever hear about Capo?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, the artist Capo, the Pocomania revivalist man.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, I just say give my insignia. Sam Clayton, you know who named Sam Clayton?
Mm-hmm.
From the Mystic Revelation of Rastafari, right?
Yeah, man.
Yes. All right, me I say, this is the thought now, and if and is it possible, and maybe it could have happened, and maybe this, I don't know, those talk, you know, those start leading to some thinking. It start make you start thinking, say, maybe I'm true, you know, and you know, like I said, you know, what's up. You know, see, we can't entertain them, and but in my mind, you know, straight at the arrow, we can't if and but. Why, you know, say, it possible, him could have come here still, and nobody don't know, you know, maybe him come here still, and no, Rasta.
So, all right, Muta, why the Rasta the banana tell lie? Why it would be a lie?
Because them want the thing, just like what the man say, I just to trouble after about the 13 times before jump on the ground. Just like how Bernie Spears make that tune that the lion crown him. The lion never crown I just say. It's Abuna put the crown upon the Ethiopian Coptic Church. Abuna put the crown upon I just head. So all of these things is to make Haile Selassie look greater than what he means. You can't make Haile Selassie greater or lesser than who he means. It's just simple. So when I entertain a talk about possible and maybe and yeah, but it's possible same could have cut off the 13 times, you know, kind of God. All this foolishness.
No,
Haile Selassie is a man.
Yeah.
He walk upon water and he not fly without plane. Because you have some man say Haile Selassie never come upon no plane.
No, we're not
believing. You never hear that yet?
No, we're not believing at them something, my lad. Because
no, but if you're not believing at that, why you entertain a thought in your head? Say? There's a possibility and might be and could be and maybe. No, sir.
Because
I just did not come here for no private visit.
No, is a government official that you know, Zane, and he's yeah. also the king of Ethiopia. So me know yes. him could do what him want to do in terms of following the protocols. You see,
but a private visit means him go through. There's no way the king of any country going to come here, and the government of Jamaica don't know.
No, but the government would have to know. That's how him going to follow
the government know. We would have know, but him don't come visit me. Him don't go in our stadium. And him don't go in a king's house.
No, but
and him don't go take a train and go to Montego Bay. That is what he call private now, is that him don't do all of these things. Him come specifically to someone, which is the government. And it's not Prince Emmanuel.
why it couldn't be Prince Emmanuel?
Well, it's a situation. We can't, it could be and would be and should be, you know.
All right.
I mean, that could be, that would be, you know. Why would he go to Prince Emmanuel? The question is not why wouldn't. What is the purpose of a private visit from Ethiopia to see Prince Emmanuel? What did the Bobo tell you?
Right. So.
What did the Bobo tell you?
The private visit, Zane. Yeah. I only hear about the private visit. Right.
Yeah, what was the private visit
about? Smash that subscribe button. See you on the next video. I just got the mindset. Smash that subscribe button. See you on the next video. I just got the mindset.